afternoon, everybody. It is both an honor and a privilege to be able to introduce one and all present here to a revered personality of note. Mr. Ajay Jhunjhunwala has distinguished himself as a people's person with an ability to understand and a flair to design, innovate, and implement people-centric strategies to fit the needs of the organization. With more than 15 years of experience in HR, sales, and business development, he is one of the very few professionals to have operational and marketing experiences before taking on a full-time responsibility of HR. Before starting his career, Mr. Jhunjhunwala graduated with the Bachelor's of Commerce as well as Bachelor's of Law degree from University of Calcutta. And then he went on to attain a Master's in International Business from IIT Mumbai and PGC HRM from XLRI Jamshedpur. He has served as a top brass of human resources departments of esteemed organizations like Angel Broken Services and Sahara India, and presently holds a position of Senior VP HR and Head HR of Anand Rathi Financial Services. Sir, we are elated to have a great educator amongst us, and the stage is all yours, sir.
Good evening, friends. I know these post-lunch sessions are really difficult. So how many of you are feeling sleepy? Lot many, not bad. At least I appreciate your honesty. So after your marathons of presentations by the dignitaries here, myself, Ajay Jhunjhunwala, as they have, you know, kind of detailed my profile in front of you, I'll be presenting in front of you the emerging challenges in human resource. But in this presentation, I am not only talking about the emerging challenges, I would also talk about certain other things which will be useful to you. So let me ask you guys can see the slide. It's a kind of a funny slide.
There are MBA first year students, and there are MBA second year and final year students. So now this slide becomes relevant for the past and future. Future for BBA students, past for already MBA students, be it first year or be it second year. How many of us have actually thought or actually decided the real reason behind doing our MBA program? So maybe I am kind of taking you in your past, the time you kind of thought about your MBA program, that you want to do MBA. Some of you got a, you know, kind of call letter from Balaji. So it's a prestigious institute. So you thought, now let's give a try. I have already got a, you know, kind of MBA call offer from Balaji, which is a good institute, structured program, 100% placement. So let's give a try. And many more reasons, I don't know. So the point which I'm trying to make here is that bygone is bygone. I don't know with what reason you guys have come here. And now some of you are already in the first year, some of you are there in the second year, and some of you are still daydreaming about this slide, wherein you are also thinking, what is my reason for doing an MBA? Or actually, do I want to become an MBA to become a CEO of the company, or to become the HR head of the company, or operations head of the company? Are you guys there with me?
Yes,
so this slide kind of becomes relevant for all the three generations which are sitting here. Now, let me take you to the next slide, where I am making you feel very, very important. You MBA graduates, have you ever thought, how many of you feel that you are important? Please raise your hand. How many of you feel you are important? Very nice. So majority, 95% of the people think they are important. How many of you feel that you are privileged? How many of you feel that you are privileged? So around 70% of us that feel that we are privileged. Very nice. Now I am telling you the reason why you are privileged and why you are important. Because you are among the 0.02% of your entire India's population. You are one among the 3.4 lakh MBA graduates which are coming out of India every year. That is the reason you are important. That is the reason you are privileged. Not everybody have those dreams. Not everybody have those resources. Not everybody is taking those chances in life to become an MBA. But possibly you guys have done all of that, and today you are sitting here. So you guys are important. Always take yourself really important and privileged. And now the real test. See, in one slide, I have kind of taken you in the past. In the next slide, I have, you know, kind of garlanded you with being very, very important. And now see the next slide. This is the reality, my friend. This is the reality. With the cap of being an MBA, you have lot of responsibilities and lot of rights have been taken away from you. Today, when I am taking an interview, you cannot tell me that I don't know this answer. I will simply tell you that you cannot tell me that you don't know because you are an MBA. Tag, MBA. Among the 0.02% of the entire India's population. If a graduate is telling me that I don't know the answer, I can still, you know, kind of accommodate for a moment. But MBA, no. You are a highest degree holder in this country. You are an MBA. So now, welcome to the slaughterhouse. Welcome to the cruel world of corporate. I will not tell you very nice things about the corporate. Corporate world is what it is. And you guys will realize it once you venture there. So possibly you guys were good enough without being an MBA. But now the slogging life starts. Today you are slogging with your assignments, with your books, toddling between your library and the lab to get your course complete. I am told there is 95% attendance compulsory here. My God. I am told that if you are caught napping in the class, you have got 3 days of voluntary sleeping time. Superb. Yeah? It's so nice, no? You nap and get 3 days of nap at a stretch. So I am really happy about these regulations. Very, very happy. I was really happy to see your classrooms non-air conditioned. Because the first thing which the MBA institutes are providing to the student today is comfort and air-conditioned lifestyle, which is kind of making lot of aspirations and lot of daydreaming in your mind, which is not true. Because you will try to look for the same comfort in the corporate world. Tomorrow you will come and join me and you will tell me, sir, what about my laptop? I'm sorry, my friend, we don't give laptops. So what do you give? I give used desktops. Used desktops. I don't even give you a new desktop. Why? Why a desktop has been given to you? It has been given to you for doing your work. How does it matter whether it's a used laptop, a used desktop, or it's a new desktop? As long as it's working, it is workable for you. So boss, now you guys have kind of taken that plunge from that easy life, and you yourself have selected this. So now you have, you know, kind of completed or about to complete your MBA course, and then the real life starts. I mean, in my slide, you can see you are happy that the MBA course is over. Now you will settle down with various aspects, settle down with your course, settle down with, I don't know. I don't want to come in front of, you know, the young people like you. You better understand. But the real life begins now, when you will go to the corporate world, when you will have to actually slog, where you will be actually penalized for coming late. 3 late is equal to 1 minus attendance. Where you have fixed timing to come, but no timing to go. Any kind of work profile, I mean, be it you in a marketing job, you are in an HR job, in an operations job, work is work. I usually tell my people that I don't work by the watch, I work by the work. So people, if they ask me the office timing, I tell them, boss, 9:30 is the starting time and ending time is up to you. What time you complete your work? So you guys are really happy that all your assignments are over, all have been submitted, marks are only due, and now you will be graduate, and then you will go out with flying colors in the corporate world. The corporate world will come here with all, you know, rosy promises, they will take you, and then the real life starts. The day you will start going to the corporate world. You are excited that you have a job offer. That is what I was about to tell you. That, you know, once our course is over and once we have a offer letter from a very good company, you know, you will be actually elated. Very, very happy. You will call your parents, you'll call your girlfriends, you'll call your boyfriends. Oh, I have got a job. Now I can talk to your parents. Now our life will be good. My friend, the life is only starting. It is just the beginning. Now, there are two schools of thought in my next line which I have written there. Jack of all, master of none. Versus jack of all, but master of one. Now it completely depends upon you. What do you want to become? People used to say that, you know, you should be knowledgeable in all the aspects. If I take the example of HR people today, I have met up with a lot of senior HR people, and they are saying, if I ask them about financial numbers, if I ask them about the turnover of their company, well, I'm sorry, I am not looking into it. I'm an HR professional. Boss, HR is no HR job nowadays. All the HR jobs, or most of the HR jobs, are getting outsourced to a third-party company. Then what will you do? Recruitments are getting outsourced to recruitment outsourcing company. Payroll is getting outsourced to payroll outsourcing company. Training departments are getting outsourced to training to a third-party outsourced company. So then is the HR department going to get dead? The answer is no. HR department needs to have the other skills, because today HR have started getting a seat in board. HR is sitting in the decision-making process. If they are sitting in the decision-making process, they will have to understand the financial numbers. They will have to understand how to increase the productivity. They are acting as business partners. So what I mean to say is, if at all you are studying marketing, you are not only restricted to Kotlers of this world. If you are doing finance, you are not only restricted to finance. You should be expert in your financial acumen, but you should have knowledge of other aspects too. That's very, very important. We check a lot of things at the interview stage. People kind of study so hard, they have kind of mugged up everything, they have even done the mock interview, even the institutes are providing their mock interview classes before the actual placement starts. And the guys goes there and become dumbo. Sir, I have become nervous. Imagine what happens if the pilot becomes nervous while flying. Imagine your Uber driver becomes nervous while taking you at the back seat. What will you do? Will you pardon him? The answer is no. I am told that the institute is providing you newspapers here. Economic Times and Indian Express. How many of you are actually reading the newspaper? Not 100%, 50%. Good enough. 50%? Very good. The number is really good. I met up with a couple of students post the budget. MBA freshers, I don't want to name the institute. And I asked them, what were the highlights of yesterday's budget? No idea. Sir, yesterday my mom was unwell, so I have not seen the television. Very good. If life can be lived on reasons, there are enough reasons we can give. Enough reasons. Today we all have smartphones. In smartphones, you can do all kind of smart things. It depends on you. Whether you want to have YouTube, whether you want to have Netflix, or whether you want to have NDTV, or you want to have ET. It completely depends on you. This is your life, my friend. In one of my pointers, I have written there, life is consequential, life is selfish. In my opinion, life will only give you what you give to life. You will have to give something to life to get something from life. How many of you have gone to Bombay? Very nice. How many of you have gone in front of Worli Beach? So many of you. Or Juhu Beach for that matter. So many of you. How many of you want to have a bungalow in front of Juhu Beach or Worli Beach? See, so many people are aspiring. Now, can I ask you the action plan? Can I ask you the action plan? Or can I ask you, by when do you want to have a bungalow in front of a Worli Beach? Bungalows in front of Worli Beach or Juhu Beach can either be inherited if your fathers were smart or grandfathers were rich, or can be created in your lifetime if at all you are ready to give that to life. I have got hundreds of examples from my batch itself. My batchmates who were there with me in my school time, today they are the directors of the company and today they are drawing a salary of 1.5 CR per annum. They can afford a flat, they can afford a bungalow in front of Worli Beach. But how many of you can reach to that level? It depends on you. That is why I'm saying life is consequential. Life is selfish. It demands some tapasya. It demands some amount of work from you. It demands some amount of hunger from you. People who are getting those kind of salaries, they have not come from Mars. They are also from here. They have given that kind of time, that kind of work, that kind of acumen to the organizations, and they have got those things in return. So how many of you are ready to give that kind of work to the corporate? How many of you are ready to, you know, kind of give that kind of efforts, that kind of work to the corporate so that, you know, you get those kind of things in return? Like maybe a bungalow in front of Worli Beach or anything for that matter. A Mercedes in a lifetime or a BMW in a lifetime. I'm told BMW comes, starting price is 30 lakhs. Now who will be able to pay 30 lakhs? One who's earning 1 CR will be able to pay 30 lakhs. Somebody who's earning 25 lakhs will not be able to pay the EMI of BMW also. So boss, understand, there is a difference between aspiration, dream and reality. The sooner you understand this difference, the better it is for you. And I am saying very simple, either you crush your dreams or you do something about it. Otherwise, it will be really painful for you. 10 years from now, if you will not be successful, you will not only tarnish your image, but you will also, you know, kind of abuse your alumni matter. Alma mater, Balaji Institute. Because you are not successful, you will say, oh, my alma mater has not taught me anything. They have not given me good placement. The point is, today's youth lack patience. Today's youth have got that self-principled ideas in their mind. On the seventh day of a new joinee fresher, somebody coming and telling me, sir, what if we do the things like this in the company? My God. Boss, you are a fresher. This is your seventh day in the company and you have started giving gyan to me. अभी आप आए हैं कंपनी में अभी कुछ समझिए कुछ सीखिए कुछ काम करिए कुछ डिलीवरी दीजिए अपना परफॉर्मेंस दिखाइए उसके बाद आप बोलिए ना दादा आपकी बात सुनूंगा मैं सातवें दिन आप हमको बताने लगे कि जो आप इतने दिनों से चला रहे हैं वो सही नहीं है गाइज लेट मी टेल यू द हार्श रियलिटी विच टूडेज यूथ इज फेसिंग एंड इफ दे डोंट चेंज इट इमीडिएटली इट विल बी रियली टफ फॉर देम वॉट इज हैपनिंग टूडे इज यू गाइज आर गेटिंग प्लेस्ड by Balaji Institute to one or the other companies. You are also reading the JD of the job. The companies are also trying to explain you in the best possible manner. they are also trying to explain you the components of the salary. Ki boss 3 lakh rupaye ke andar mein, 5 lakh rupaye ke andar mein, 10 lakh rupaye ke andar mein, what will be your take home salary? Salaries and everything, all those components are really funny. So mera suggestion aap logon se ki jab bhi aap log pre-placement offer ya unse baatcheet karenge, clear sari cheeze samajh lijiyega. Ki boss, what amount of money I will be getting in hand out of the fat salary which you are showing me. But once you are signing on those dotted lines that yes, I am joining your company, then be with that company for some time, no? The problem today's youth is facing is they are going in the company, they are trying to do the work, they are trying to do the work, their dreams are shattered, they thought of a cabin, they thought of a, you know, kind of steward standing outside their cabin, you know, to serve them tea, whereas, you know, the teas are coming twice in the organization or there are vending machines. So the dreams are anyway shattered on one hand. On the other hand, the boss's pressure is there. What, where is the sales? Or you know, they are giving you the sarcastic statement, what have you learned in your MBA colleges? You don't even know MS Excel? So the point is, we are freshers, we know that. So we will have to keep that in our mind and we will have to keep reminding ourselves that yes, boss, we are new, we are freshers. And the only thing I tell my people is that you should become like a soaker. There are soakers in the toilet which soaks water and the soap. In the first few days, first few months in any organization, you should simply become like that soaker in which you are only soaking things. Whatever you are observing, whatever you are seeing, and whatever people are telling you. Please keep your, you know, your gyan, your principles, your statements, your understanding of the things for a while. First deliver and then ask for things and have patience. After spending 7-8 months in the company, your friend calls you, another friend from Balaji calls you and tells you, hi, how are you, etc., etc. And then the conversation, you know, kind of goes in detail about the work which is happening in her company versus your company. And you says, yaar, my boss is really lousy. He kind of, you know, I don't know what to say. So much of pressure here. How is your job? And she says, yeah, my job is all fine. So how much salary you get? And by chance you have already told, oh, I am getting 5 lakh. What about you? I get 8 lakhs. Oh, 8 lakhs. I am getting only 5. Is there an opening in your company? And she'll tell you, yeah. There's an opening. Why don't you see me or send me your resume? And then once you send your resume and once you give the interview there, again that company will last for only 7-8 months. The trend which I have seen is, in first 3 years of newcomers joining, they are changing 5 companies because of X, Y, and Z reasons. Somewhere the reason is salary, somewhere the reason is lousy boss, somewhere the reason is wrong promises. They told me it's a marketing job and I am doing complete sales. They told me leads will be provided and today I am going door to door. And now what will happen after completion of 3 years? You will be jobless. There are no jobs offered for you. And then what will happen? Then you will go back to the pay package of the first job and then stick around your neck for some time. Understand, my friends, we all have done or we all have taken up this assignment of doing an MBA by our own means. Some people's dad have given them the money and some people have taken education loans. Education loans, paying off the education loan is not easy. It's not easy. You will have to give that kind of money every month for a couple of years. Taking education loan is very easy. And banks are sitting, you know, outside your MBA institutes. Oh, we are ready. Why don't you take it from me? But giving it back, it's really tough. So at least respect that thing, have some patience, show the delivery in the organizations and stick around. Sticking around is very, very important. That is my suggestion. Rest, as I told you, life is selfish. It is up to you. Whatever you lift, whatever you give to the life. If you don't want to give anything, fine, don't expect anything. So I have spoken about the peer pressure and the self-made principles, which are, you know, kind of very important in life, but give yourself some time. Now, as my topic says, some of the biggest HR challenges, and I have taken these challenges from the recent Deloitte survey, 2017, human capital survey which Deloitte has done with more than 10,000 people, and they have found these as the most important HR challenges. Rethinking our organization structure, upskilling our employees, acquiring new talent, driving employee culture and engagement, fixing our performance management process, and developing leaders. These are some of the challenges which Deloitte has pointed after doing a survey. I will be, you know, kind of focusing on each of them in a short while. So, organization of the future, this is a very big challenge, and this has come for the first time in the trend. Sorry, it was there even last year as one of the challenges in the Deloitte survey, wherein the, and this cross marks are nothing but the result of the poll. How many people are saying what they have in their organization? So, majority of the people are saying that it is hierarchical in nature. Network, few people are saying network. Network of teams, again, very few people are saying network of teams, and completely unorganized. Many more people are saying completely organized, completely unorganized. So this is very, very important aspect. We will have to understand what kind of organization is ours, whether they have the hierarchical, you know, nature in the organization, whether they have network of teams, because it completely depends upon how the organizations are working. So I am simultaneously showing you the trends, removing the percentages which the Deloitte actual report has shown. So I would urge you to go through the actual Deloitte report, which is available on the internet, and it will, you know, kind of enhance your knowledge to a better extent. So 11% believe they understand how to build the organization of the future. 94% say agility and collaborations are critical, yet nothing has been done. 8% using organization's network analysis, and 6% are highly agile today. So this is very useful for the HR professionals to understand the OD aspect of human resource, wherein they will have to see what kind of structures they have in their organization. If the structures are not in place, they will have to put the structures in place depending on what kind of structure is most suitable for them. What do you think is the half-life of learned skills today? This is very, very interesting. And the poll says, out of the three numbers given here, 15 years, 10 years, and 5 years, majority of them has said 5 years. Can anybody tell me what is half-life? Any idea what is half-life? Half-life of the learned skills? Yeah, any, there is no penalty for wrong answers. So even you can guess. Sorry? The peak time, okay. Anyone else? It is not peak time. Half time has also nothing to do with the cinema. You know, in like the, we used to have intervals in the cinema. So half time ho gaya. So this is not that half time. Any? Sorry, yeah, please repeat. Sorry, very good. So you are kind of talking about the output, but you're not talking about the what is half time. You're right in what you're saying, but the definition of half time is this. Half time is the time that it takes for anything or any quantity to diminish to half its initial value. So now what you said is written there. Skills are getting outdated very soon. So you guys are saying that you are doing your first MBA. I am saying, what if you are an MBA? Maybe after 7 years down the line, you will have to again upgrade your skills, because your skills are getting redundant in 5 years' time. In 5 years' time, whatever you have learned is becoming redundant. Now what? So you'll have to keep on upgrading yourself. That is as it has been seen that people are spending more time in YouTube watching videos than the TV time. So don't think that ek MBA ho gaya, kaam khatam. So whoever have taken loan for this, for doing this MBA, my request to them is that finish up that loan first, fast, so that you can take another for doing second MBA. No, because you will have to upgrade your skills. 5 saal, 7 saal, 8 saal ke andar mein it will become redundant. Or naya kya? You will have to do micro certifications. There are a lot of certification programs available these days. You will have to start doing those certifications again and again. Either your organizations will help you to do that, or you yourself will have to do it. If you are not working in an organization which is kind of employee friendly or investing in their employees for the micro certifications, you will have to do it. Because ultimately, you know, you will have to reap the benefit of your education and your career throughout your life. Throughout your life. Aisa nahi hai ki ye MBA ki life agle 6 saal hai ya 7 saal hai aur 7 saal ke baad mein aap zero ho jayenge. Nahi, aisa nahi hai. Your salaries will keep on increasing, your roles will keep on increasing, you will keep on rising in your career. So you will have to simultaneously, you will have to keep on upgrading yourself. Generation Z career versus our parents' career. It has been seen that our parents only had one career. They have spent their entire lifetime in one organization. At best, two organizations. But Generation Z, the data says, have got 27 careers. 27 careers. So that is what I was telling to you. Now you will have to decide. I am not saying that, you know, you will have to spend your entire lifetime in one organization only, but then at least spend a good amount of time in any organization. And in my opinion, as an HR professional, 3 to 4 years is a good enough time in one organization. And another way to evaluate is, as long as if you are getting two promotions and two increments, two promotions, if you are getting in one organization, it is a good enough time. We don't take it as an instability when you are kind of portraying your resume in front of us. And ideally, two promotions one should get in 4 years' time. So 4 years' time is a good enough time. And then it completely depends upon your objective of doing the job. The objective which I think, there are three prominent objectives because of which anybody is working. The first and the foremost objective is, can anybody tell me? First and the foremost objective because of which you are working. Why do you work? Loudly? Money. Very good. So first and foremost objective is money. What about second? Sorry? Recognition. So in my opinion, there are simple three things. One is money, second is growth, and third is learning. So as long as you are able to learn and contribute and at the same time grow and earn money for yourself, you are home, no? Why will you change jobs? Why will you change jobs? Right now, just for, I'm sure all of you are aware, for your information, gratuity laws have not changed. Government is simply proposing or have proposed that, you know, employers should give gratuity every year. But otherwise the current norms is 5 years. So at least take the gratuity. It is a generous amount of money which the company is giving. And in some of the companies, gratuity is also not part of your CTC. If it is not part of your CTC, it is extra money which you are getting after 5 years. This is another 10 data. Which technology are you using for recruitment? Are organizations using chatbots, predictive analysis, videos, gaming, all of the above, none of the above? The recent trend shows that very scarce amount of companies are using video, predictive analysis, gaming, and most of them are not using anything. So guys, we will have to understand that the things are changing, the world is changing, digital era, in the digital era, if at all we don't go with the world, we will be lag behind. So now what it brings for us, it brings to us that, you know, if we are taking video interviews, it is kind of reducing some amount of biases.
we all individuals have got inherent biases in us. When we take interviews, those biases play the role. So at least when the machine is taking the interview, those biases will be wiped out. If the JDs are getting screened by a technological tool, the biases will be wiped out. So it is only to remove the human biases, because different HODs, different stakeholders have got different ways of doing things. It is also kind of making structured approach. Because if the machine is taking it, machine only understands the instruction. And you have given the instruction to the machine, machine is accordingly doing its work. Today, it is actually, in spite of such a huge population which India has, the employable population is not there. We all have problems, we all have a firefighting problems when it comes to talent acquisition. And be it any profile, be it HR profile, be it finance profile, be it marketing profile, be it research profiles. Abundant of CVs, abundant of candidates are available. But are they fitting the job role? The answer is no. I have a very funny data with me. When we post a HR job in any of the job boards, we get 5,000 resumes. In spite of specifying the details there, that people from XYZ industries should only apply. In spite of that, we get 5,000 resumes, and trust me guys, this I'm telling you out of the real-time experience, not even 5 resumes are relevant out of 5,000. 5,000. Look at the ratio. So the point is, there are a lot of talent available in this world, in India itself. But then the point is, how much of it is useful to me? Because I will screen you as per my job role, as per your fitment in the role which I am looking for. So abundance of talent is there, and we all are, you know, kind of fishing in the same pond. So what one of the US companies did, where this is one of the hot skills HTML 5, what they did is, they kept a free certification program for HTML 5. Thousands apply, hundreds cleared the exam, and they have taken them on the rolls of the job. And what were the profiles of these people who kind of cleared this exam? They were disc washers. They were recruiters. There were other people whom the organization never thought can also do HTML 5 work. But then possibly they had the aptitude of doing it, which we were not able to ascertain. So now if the ready-made talent is not available, we will have to make the talent. We will have to manufacture the talent. So there the, you know, the work of freshers comes into picture. That yes, we will take the, you know, freshers in abundance, we will make them what we want them to be, and then maybe 3 years, 3 months, 6 months down the line, they are ready-made material. So organizations have started doing it. In fact, in our organization, we also do that. We also hire from a couple of campuses. Then we take them under a strenuous training program. And post that, you know, they are kind of ready-made material for the job which we have in hand. How often do companies measure employee engagement? This data is kind of making many people nervous, because the majority of them are not doing it within a year. So less than a year, the majority of them is the answer. With this, the question comes that on one hand, we are saying that people are our most important resource. And on the other hand, we are also not able to find, or we are not able to take the feedback from them, that how happy, how engaged they are in the company. Imagine a situation if we are doing the same thing with our customers. Do we treat our customers in a similar manner? The answer is no. It will be suicidal. So if we are not treating our customer in this manner, why are we treating our employees? We will have to understand how engaged they are, and then only we can fix up some problems. We are not doing it. Majority of the companies are not doing it. Suppose if any HR department or L&D department is even taking up this project, from the time they are taking the project, the data says that if they are taking this project in month 1, the project implementation is going in month 10. Month
10. 10 months are passed in understanding the need analysis, in doing the survey, and you know, in taking the approvals, presenting it to the board, and finally in 10th month, we are thinking about kind of projecting it for the next year. So by that time, the new problems have already come. So what about the old problems? What about the old gaps which we have? So this is the data. 22% are excellent at building a differentiated employee experience. 23% believe their employees are fully aligned with the corporate purpose. 10% are using design thinking as part of crafting the employee experience. 14% believe their internal process for collaboration and design making are working well. The definition of culture and the engagement as per what Deloitte thinks, as per what they have, you know, kind of designed this survey, is culture is how things actually get done in the organization, and engagement is how we feel about them. And to an extent, this is also what, you know, kind of we believe the definitions of culture and engagement. How do you think your employees feel about performance engagement at your company? This is the data. What we have seen is performance management discussions, performance management processes, they are kind of a platform to only discuss about individual employees' raise, individual employees' performances, individual employees' bonuses to be paid in that particular year. Hardly companies are talking about their developmental needs, their developmental programs, which is the need of the hour. Fine, performance management, we are talking about their raise, we are talking about their bonuses, but then the focus should be towards the developmental needs. Because ultimately, otherwise, you yourself is making your employees redundant in the company. Same work they are doing again and again, again and again, again and again. Tomorrow, if the question of job rotation will come, the employee will not be ready because he is not ready actually. Because you have never looked into his developmental need. So he is only expert in one particular aspect, which he wants to continue doing for the rest of his life. We have actually not, you know, kind of kept our watch towards the other skills which the employee can ingrain. So opinion-based to data-based, and the third part is from secretive to transparent. This is very, very important, because all this while we have seen majority of companies, they keep the performance management process as very, very secretive. There are even circulars in the company which kind of goes to every employees saying that, you know, each other's data should not be shared with each other. When we are doing individual discussions also, if the employee asks about somebody else, we say, no, that is none of your business. Another important tool, leadership. Which capability is most important for a leader to be successful? And this is the trend data says. And the majority of point goes to ability to build and lead team. With regard to this particular topic, organizations have understood that, you know, there is a need. And post 2008 has already taught them that why leadership is required. Those drop in the economy, global economy has, recession has taught them why, you know, leaders at the bench are required. But then nothing has been done from the organization side with regard to leadership development. Because it is a time-consuming process, it is an investment, it is an expensive process, which organizations are, you know, only they are realizing, but they are not kind of investing amount on these aspects. So leadership can't be taught, but sadly organizations are not investing enough on leadership development. And even if they are developing, even if they are investing the money, they want return in no time, which is not possible. Digital HR, the term itself was very, very, you know, kind of confusing 3 years back. But now, you know, all of us are aware about this term. What does digital HR means? And these are the three ingredients of digital HR. And at least in this particular aspect, organizations have given equal weightages to all the three points. People with digital DNA who drive innovation, platform and tools that enable productivity, a design thinking approach for doing work. Now, future HR says 56% are redesigning their HR programs to leverage digital and mobile tools. 33% are using same form or artificial intelligence technology to deliver HR. Now, my point with regard to all the points which I have shown you just now, which are the challenges, and with the challenges, I also discussed the solutions which are available, which the organizations either want to embrace or don't want to embrace. So the point is, the organizations which will embrace will bring change, will be there in the rat race. Organizations who will not embrace, sooner or later you will see they'll become obsolete. Now it completely depends upon the organization, whether they want to embrace or whether they want to face the consequence. And with this, I have this famous quote. If you keep doing what you have always done, you will keep getting what you have always got. And the same applies for organizations, the same applies for you guys also. If you guys want to be what you were 10 years back, the result will be same. Here I want to tell you a small story. It's an interesting story, don't worry. I mean, all of them are thinking, oh, he has now started telling stories. Anyways, they're telling the story from the last 45 minutes. It's an interesting story and it will help you in your future life as well. So there was this wise old man in the village, and there was this young boy. This wise old man was very much regarded and respected in that entire village by all the people. And this young boy had some rift with this wise old man. He always wanted to put him down. He always wanted to make him fool. Want to prove himself, prove this old man a fool in front of all the village. So he kind of thought of a plan. He said, I will, you know, kind of frame a scheme in my mind. He bought a bird from the forest, a feeble bird from the forest, and cupped that bird in his hand. And he thought that I will go and ask this wise old man in front of all the villagers, whether this, what I have in my hand, and he will obviously say that, yeah, you have got bird in your hand. And then I will ask him whether the bird is dead or alive. And then if he says the bird is dead, I will open my hand and the bird will fly. If he says the bird is alive, I will crush and kill the bird in my hand and will prove him wrong. So with this plan, he called all the villagers there and called this wise old man. And he said, wise old man, please tell me what I have in my hand. He said, you have bird in your hand, my son. And then further he said, tell me whether the bird is alive or dead. Wise old man paused for a second, looked into the eyes of this young boy and said, my son, the bird is in your hand. With this, I end my story and I end my session. So my friends, the bird is in your hands.